Welcome to another episode of Liberty Creek. On this episode, I'm going to attempt to answer my number one question I get from my subscribers, and that is, what plans did you use to build your cabin? Well, I went on Amazon for 50 bucks. I bought these plans right here. What comes with these plans? Well, two sets of blueprints, two sets of material list, and an artist rendering. All the plans that you need to build a 24 by 24 cabin. The creator of this puts right here that he designed the plan for novice to be able to read blueprints, blah, 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 blah. There's the artist rendering. For all my subscribers, you know that does not look like my cabin. If you're not a subscriber, hit the subscribe button. It's down here somewhere. And there's a reason for that. These plans are great. It's a great launching pad for your imagination, and it gives you direction to go, especially if you're a novice, to start the build and to get it going. Okay, here on the third page, you're going to start talking about the foundation. Okay, these plans are basic plans, you know, foundation, get your structure going. But if you don't have any experience at all, you're not going to be able to buy these plans, read them, and know everything you need to know to build this structure. I'm sorry, this guy claims he did that, but trust me, he didn't, okay? You're going to get to a page like this and say, huh, what's a header? What's a king stud? You're going to get to the point to install your window. You're not going to know how to do it correctly, how to put the drainage in and stuff like that. So what I would highly recommend you to do is, there's nothing wrong with these blueprints. Like I said, they're a great launching point for your imagination in the build. They give you direction. And these do give you direction to the foundation, to the platform, to the walls, to the roof, okay? Like, if you look right here, it's gonna start talking about your roof, your trusses. But the thing here is, they don't tell you how to make those trusses. They might give you some numbers and stuff, but right here, it's only an example. They recommend you should have it designed by an engineer. And the reason for that, I'm pretty sure it would be liability, because each location, you need to know your snow load of what type of truss you could put up there, okay? So what I did when I got to this point is I went down to the Home Depot. You could purchase trusses right from them. They get it engineered, and they walk you through this computer program, and you could put a room up on the second floor. All I did is cathedral ceiling, kept it simple. I give them my zip code. They know what the snow loads are for every zip code in America. They make sure that your roof will withstand a hard winter. Last winter, in my location, I get a lot of snow, and I had no problems. With the pitch of my roof, snow sheds, okay? I have a pretty steep pitch, and it always came right off. So these are the things to keep in mind when you purchase plans. You're not going to get all the answers. You're going to be going through this and be kind of puzzled, okay? But you'll get through it. Use some stuff like YouTube, books. Go find someone with the knowledge and talk to them. Go on some forums. My build series, I have a build series. I'll pop it up in the corner here. Go ahead and watch it. My build series is what I did to build my cabin, okay? You do what you want to do. It's not a how to build a cabin. It's what I did, how I built my cabin. And my cabin will outlast me, okay? So I got a lot of naysayers too, but they're sitting there watching my videos of me building the cabin from their couch, okay? So don't tell me, oh, I would have done this. Well, go do that. There's a lot of things that people just wanted me to do different. I should have had a basement. I had this one guy, oh, you should have done basement. I'm trying to build a cabin on the cheap in the woods so I could go and enjoy. And I don't think, I got dried in with $7,000 just under a year on the weekends, $7,000. I got my cabin dried in. If I was sitting there digging basements and putting up basement walls and, you know, all this money on cement and all this stuff, it would have cost a lot more than $7,000. I would have been building something that I didn't want. That's all I got for this episode, folks. I'll be going up to Vermont this weekend. I'm going to bring up more pine, finish up the back wall in the bathroom. I'm going to attempt to fix the stove. This is what I took out of the stove. As you can see, the heat elements here all snapped off. So I got a new one. We'll put that on and I hope it works. But thanks for watching. Go ahead and hit that notification button. I hope everyone has a great day. Thanks for watching.